So now we are going to learn about the issuance procedure of the strata title that we just spent half an hour to look at just now, okay? Now, issuance procedure says that under land law, the land title is the result of land alienation. Okay, process tu namanya land alienation. Under strata law pula, strata title is the result of building or land subdivision. Pecah bahagi. Dia pecah bahagi. Untuk land, alienation ialah pemberi milikan. Yes. Dalam kes strata law, pecah bahagi. Bangunan atau tanah. Now, the procedure for strata titles under Strata Titles Act and STA is under part 2 and also part 3 of STA. Part 2, application for subdivision of building under section 6-14. Part 3, registration of strata titles. Register is everything. Ya, yeah, kan kata je kan? So, how to register sections 15-19. Now, so this is the new regime. With the introduction of SMA, dia memperkuatkan, dia strengthen the process of strata title issuance procedure, okay? Under STA. So must be read together. Baru kita faham macam mana regimenya, the new regime for strata development from planning permission sampailah sale. So now, if you want to, if you want to undertake, kalau kita nak jalankan satu strata development, we begin with the getting the development order or planning permission. Apa-apa kan kita dah belajar before this kan? Mesti dapatkan planning permission, mesti dapatkan building plans. Okay? Dekat mana? Dekat OSC. Okay? Local authority kan? We submit the applications to OSC at the local authority. Sama ada untuk dapatkan planning permission, untuk dapatkan building plan, lagi land matters di OSC juga. Okay? Tapi yang akan approve adalah state authority kan, sebab land is on the state. But anyway, bila saja we submit the applications, together with the submission, we also must submit for strata development the CIFUS. CIFU, sijil, formula, unit share. And just now I showed you the share units. Inilah, any new developments from the onset, from the beginning, nampak ni, sale start ni. Daripada awal lagi, share units kena dikira. You have to calculate the share units. You have to determine, you have to list down in a sijil, in a certificate. Tapi CIFUS ni lagi famous daripada nama Englishnya. So we call it CIFUS. Okay? Sijil, formula, unit share. The unit share itself together with the formula will be shown in the CIFU. CIFUS kena submit to PTG. Then together with that, we have the developer also has to submit the schedule of parcels. Schedule of parcels menunjukkan all the list of the parcels together with the accessory parcels. Okay, we will have a look what SOP looks like. Schedule of parcels look like. Tetapi the point is from the beginning semua ini dah di submit. You have to submit all these to the local authority, to the relevant authorities. So in the case of CIFUS to the PTG, in the case of SOP, the schedule of parcels with the Commissioner of Building. Commissioner of Building terletak di local authority juga. Okay. Parcel, kemudian barulah boleh dijual, sale of parcels. Okay. Bila dapat kebenaran ini, for residential juga you perlu dapat license. From sorry, developers license and permit from KPKT, Kementerian Perumahan dan KPKT, Kerajaan Tempatan, and then barulah you boleh jual you punya parcels petak. Okay, so this is a summary of what we mentioned just now. This one lah, dalam bentuk yang lebih complex. Okay, beginning from planning permission until the strata title transfer, because we dah jual kan just now. You sale, after sale, dah jual. Okay, then constructionnya after, sebab we use the sell then build kan. Sell then build punya model. So meaning you can sell your parcels you, even before construction is completed. Semasa construction pun you dah boleh jual. Bila reach a superstructure, the superstructure stage, okay, you bolehlah apply for building or land subdivision. You bolehlah apply for strata titles. Di sini point dia. Point to apply for strata titles di sini. Di sini. So here is just about the development process. Okay, development process. Okay, nothing to do with the strata titles lagi. Belum lagi. Ini cuma untuk development of strata development sahaja. Okay. This is what we mentioned just now. The documents tak pun boleh baca sendirilah. Okay. Then bila dah capai superstructure stage, you can apply for building or land subdivision. Apakah superstructure stage? Nanti boleh kita akan learn more below what is superstructure stage. Actually, that's when all the partitions sudah siap dalam. So it says that when the building superstructure is completed within 3 months from the issuance of the document that certifies the superstructure stage. Bila keluar satu perakuan bahawa superstructure stage sudah dicapai, okay, dalam setiap bulan, or within 3 months from the issuance of CCC, bila bangunan dah siap, ini untuk untuk new development sekarang, ataupun yang pembangunan yang sudah sedia ada, bila bangunan tu sudah siap, bila CCC sudah keluar, okay, dikeluarkan, the licensed land surveyor needs to submit all proposed strata plan to JUPEM. So means the land surveyor yang kita kawan kita yang buat BSc in land surveying tu kan, dulu kerja sikit, dulu tak popular. Kita kata jadi land surveyor, you kena bawa general light, you tengah panas, hitam kulit kan, gaji tak seberapa. Sekarang they are making a lot of money, okay? Because land surveyors now also are involved in the strata title punya issuance, because they are the ones who survey, they are the ones who ukur the peta. Okay? Then the licensed land surveyor needs to submit all proposed strata plan. Dia akan survey the strata development, dan dia akan come up with the proposed strata plan. Proposed strata plan to JUPEM to apply for the CPSP, certificate of proposed strata plan. CPSP adalah satu requirement untuk strata title issuance. Siapa yang apply for the subdivision? I mentioned yesterday, is the original proprietor yang mesti apply for subdivision. Bukannya developer, kalau kebetulan developer dan proprietor tu orang yang sama, then developer proprietor slash developer lah. Tetapi kalau katakan it's a joint venture, proprietor tu perbadanan PKNS, developer tu satu syarikat, katakan SP Setia kan. Siapa yang buat permohonan pecah bahagi bangunan? It's not SP Setia, it's the PKNS yang akan kena apply for building subdivision ataupun land subdivision. Okay, within 3 months from the date of issuance or documents that certifies from the certificate of superstructure stage just now, dalam masa 3 bulan. Dan ini kita akan belajar apa syarat-syarat yang membolehkan kita buat application tersebut. Tanah tersebut mesti mematuhi, tanah, the master title must fulfill 3 criteria. This we will mention below, section 9. Okay? Application for strata title, where do you do the application? Where do you make the application? You submit the application to PTG, approval is by PTG, preparation and approval of strata preparation and approval of strata certified plan. Siapa yang buat? JUPEM. JUPEM kita punya ukur dan pemetaan just now. Mereka ada land surveyors. Then finally issue of strata titles by the PTG. Okay, lebih kurang sama prosesnya dengan land alienation. Mesti apply dahulu, mesti approve. Ada satu yang missing di sini ialah pembayaran. You have to pay all the required fees. Kemudian barulah prepare and approval of strata CP and then issue strata titles. Kemudian strata title yang dah dikeluarkan tu perlu diregister untuk dia take effect kan. You need to register the strata titles. Then kalau ikut dia punya turutan of development, once you register the strata title, you issue strata title which has been registered, ideally secara yang terbaik pada masa tu juga diberikan, diserahkan pemilikan kosong, issuance of vacant possession, because this will enable the MC to be formed, to be established. Okay, so condition untuk delivery of vacant possession sebagaimana kita sudah belajar sebelum ni, ada 4 syaratnya. Then transfer of strata title. Strata title first time dikeluarkan akan dikeluarkan atas nama proprietor. Okay, the strata title, the initial strata title will be on the name of PKMS. Then the strata title has to be transferred to the new owner. Hasniah TV Bin Hamzah. Kan, just now. So the process of transfer must be undertaken after the registration of strata title under the first proprietor, under the proprietor pertama. Proprietor tu maknanya tuan tanah. Okay? Sebab strata title akan dikeluarkan atas nama tuan tanah dahulu. Walaupun you sudah beli di sini, walaupun you sudah beli awal your parcel. Sebab bukti ownership at this point is just your SPA, your sale and purchase agreement. Belum lagi title. Only here your proof, only here will your proof of ownership akan diberikan oleh strata title. Then selamatlah, because register is everything, kan? So if your ownership is only proven by SMP, tak berapa selamat sebab belum register. Ada kemungkinan boleh dicabar, defeated. So indivisibility of title is only afforded, hanya diberikan di sini bila nama you sudah ada dalam strata title. Okay, hopefully that's clear. So definitions, building, lot, parcel, yeah, dan juga accessory parcel. Okay, building apa dia? And this is under Section 4 Strata Titles Act. Building, apa maksud bangunan? Any building, mana-mana bangunan, partially completed, yang separa siap ataupun to be erected ataupun yang baru hendak didirikan, proposed to be erected within a lot, di atas satu tanah. Lot ni, ini, lot tanah, ha? Within a lot, as shown or specified in any proposed strata plan submitted for approval. So that's clear lah. Mana-mana bangunan yang sedang didirikan atau proposed to be erected di atas tanah, di atas lot. What is lot? Lot here refers to surveyed plot. So the key word here is surveyed. Dia sudah disurvey, sudah ukur halus, means the boundary stones or boundary markers are known. The land area now is a surveyed land area instead of provisional land area. Bukan hak milik sementara, bukan luas tanah sementara. Dia sudah luas tanah ukur, luas ukur tanah, luas yang diukur. So surveyed plot contained in a strata plan on which accommodates the subdivided building. What is parcel? Parcel adalah any individual unit comprised within the subdivided building held under separate strata title atau that is parcel. What is accessory parcel? Accessory parcel is any parcel which is used or intended to be used in conjunction, digunakan bersama dengan parcel, dengan petak tersebut. Accessory parcel in BM ialah petak accessory. Okay, contoh carpark bay, petak parkir kereta. Accessory parcels may not be contiguous. Dia mungkin tak bersambung, tak bersentuhan, with the main parcel but are owned by the parcel proprietor and included in his title. Apa-apa yang muncul di dalam title is the accessory title, accessory parcel, walaupun tidak bersentuhan, tidak contiguous with the main parcel. Boundary dia mungkin tak bersentuhan. Mana ada kat parking lot dekat koridor kan, betul tak? Dekat third floor, 12th floor, 20th floor, mana you boleh parking, you boleh betul-betul ada pintu, cannot lah. So your parking lot is at the ground floor. On the ground floor, you have to go down using the lift, walk to the car park, barulah you sampai, kan, sama ada open air ataupun basement tu. Dia tak bersentuhan. But as long as the accessory parcels are shown in the strata title, then it is together, it comes together with the parcel. Ini dia. Tan and also Hanisa. Hani and Tan, Section 69 prohibits any dealing. So dealing sini termasuklah lease. My soalan just now. So tak boleh jual, tak boleh charge, tak boleh lease your accessory parcel separately. Tak boleh, prohibits. Dilarang of the accessory parcel independent of the main parcel. Sekiranya you nak sewakan you punya petak parking kepada satu syarikat yang nak uruskan, that that petak parking tu mesti di list together with your unit. Mana pula macam tu? You nak tinggal tinggal dalam you punya petak kan? So means essentially you tak boleh lah buat. Okay, di link means just now my example was list kan? You nak list kepada satu syarikat, maybe a parking operator kan, yang nak list selama 10 tahun. But what if you nak sewakan bulanan saja kepada orang lain? Boleh ke tak boleh? Ni soalan trik lagi. Boleh jawab tak? T Lewang. Big boss. T Lewang, can you rent out your car park separately? Rent out monthly. Can or not?
I think cannot.
Just wait, okay. The answer is can. Dealing here only refers to transfer, lease, charge. Lease, the definition, you go back to what you learn in your national
level. Now we're talking about rent, right?
Rent. Okay. Right. 3 years, okay? So that's my trick. Monthly, that is also my hint just now. Monthly means if you rent it out monthly, you can terminate monthly juga. So it's not 3 years lah. So it's not more than 3 years, okay? Can rent out but not lease. Faham tak? Two different things lah. Hopefully other classmates understand my point. You tidak boleh pajakkan you punya kapak, which is your accessory parcel, separately from your petak, tetapi you boleh rent out. You boleh sewakan. Sebab sewa tu bukan dealing. Yeah, you go back to the definition. Thank you so much, Muhammad. Okay. You boleh rent out, okay? Hadiah, birthday. Okay, anyway. Boundary, this is important as well. Boundary, mana dia punya sempadan, parcel, okay? You see here ada dua petak. We have two parcels and this is the outside, if you can imagine lah. The common boundary. Common boundary maknanya sempadan bersama. It's the center, it's always the center. Of the floor, of the wall or the ceiling between each parcel. So meaning, sebab sekarang ni petak, nama petak, we are not dealing with a two-dimensional punya property. We are dealing with a 3D punya property. Because dia ada lantai, dia ada walls, dia ada ceiling kan. So the 3D itu, boundary dengan orang bawah, orang sebelah, orang atas ialah center of the floor, center of the wall, center of the ceiling. Okay. Inilah nak tunjuknya ni center, ni semua center ni. So you share. Okay. So that's a case, an interesting case regarding boundary of parcels. Lee Wah Bank lawan Chi Leong Holding. Dalam case tersebut, okay, the appellant, I believe you sudah sampai ke Court of Appeal. The appellant meaning, mana satu ni? Bank is the appellant. Bank sebab dia nak install ATM lah. ATM tu cash machine kan. So the Lee Wah Bank, dia nak install ATM through exterior wall ni outside kan. So they want to install here the ATM machine. So ATM kan separuh dalam bank, separuh luar bank sebab you akan queue up to apa, get your money kan, your cash. Anyway, respondent Chi Lim Holding, okay. Tengok tahun 1984, this is pre-Strata Titles Act ya, tapi tak apa. Sebab sekarang ni the case itu is regarding boundary of parcels. Terguna pakai sampai sekarang. This is an original precedent case, okay. Now, the respondent who was the proprietor, the respondent was the proprietor of the land. Respondent inilah Chi Leong Holding. Dia adalah tuan tanah. Ya, yeah, mungkin original proprietor, mungkin developer, mungkin juga proprietor. Ya. Yeah. Tanah ini common property. So, bila Liwa nak tepuk, nak tepuk dinding tu sebab boundary adalah half-half kan. Half is yours. But the other half towards the outside tu belongs to the land, to the land owner, to the proprietor. So, makna you dah pakai dia punya airspace. You dah pakai dia punya land portion kan, ataupun boundary portion. So dia minta lah rent. Dia minta ask for rent because you are using this part. Okay? Berapa tak kisahlah, 200 ke 2000 ke, you are using my property, kan? People queue up using my property as well. So that's the argument. That was the argument of Chi Lim Holding. Appellant argued that it was their wall. The bank kata ini dinding saya ikut suka saya lah nak tepuk dinding pun. Nah, up to me lah if I want to, if I want to make a hole and put an ATM machine in my wall. Itu argument dia. So I don't have to pay rent to you, okay, as the landowner. But federal court stated that the external wall was a common boundary. You own half-half. Okay? And thus consent was required. Respondent has the right to refuse consent unless you pay rent. Dia memang ada hak tersebut. Therefore, the bank had to pay rent to the proprietor. So, case itu set a precedent that the boundary is half-half. To the proprietor yang ada parcel, half to the next punya proprietor. Be it next door, below or upstairs. Sebab dia share half saja. So what is common property? Common property under Strata Titles Act, Section 4. Any part of lot that is not a parcel. Mana-mana saja bahagian tanah yang mana bukan parcel, bukan petak. Termasuk accessory parcel or any provisional block as shown in the approved strata plan. So termasuklah apa-apa yang bukan parcel, apa-apa yang bukan accessory parcel, iaitu apa-apa yang bukan provisional block, iaitu contohnya lifts, water tanks, refuse chutes. Okay, ini adalah tempat you buang sampah tu. Okay, the tempat you buang sampah dekat high rise kan, so ini there's a place where you open the door to the chute and then you put the garbage and then you tutup to refuse chutes. Drains, sewers, pipes, wires, cables, ducts, semua itu, any facilities installations used in common by all purchasers adalah common property. Under SMA pula, yeah, common property ada sedikit different the definition. Common property under SMA is defined as so much of the development area. Ini sama dengan STA, not comprised in any parcel or proposed parcel. Proposed parcel, provisional block lah. Termasuklah accessory parcel. So dalam hal ini sama dengan STA definitionnya, but dia tambah, SMA tambah lagi sedikit untuk qualify for common property under SMA, katanya used or the common property tu must be used or capable of being used or enjoyed by occupiers of two or more parcels or proposed parcels. Dia letaklah satu qualifier lagi, satu syarat lagi, used or capable of being used or enjoyed by occupiers of two or more parcels or proposed parcels. Mesti dua atau lebih owners tu boleh enjoy the property, barulah dipanggil sebagai common property. Therefore, bila itu saja ditambah, dia meluaskan lagi definition of common property. So sekarang semua structural elements of the buildings, stairs, stairways, or ni fire escapes, entrance, exit, corridor, lobby, semua ini adalah common property, playing field, recreational area. So SMA, apa efeknya ialah dia mengesahkan, dia mengesahkan, clarifies what is common property. Strata register, what is that? Strata register under section which needs to be open under section 15 of Strata Titles Act, okay, ialah register. Any buku daftar, buku pendaftaran, register, either in the form of bound or unbounded volumes. Oh no, salah, this is strata roll. I made the same mistake last year, sorry everyone, I will make pembetulan. Instead of strata register, this is strata roll. A register either in the form of bound or unbounded volumes kept and maintained by the MC. MC pegang strata roll. Strata roll diletakkan di pejabat MC to keep detail records of each parcel. Okay. Strata register disimpan di PTG under section 15. Ini adalah under section 19. If I'm mistaken. Nanti kita akan clarify masa kita belajar bahasa MC itu. Okay. So ini salah. It's not strata register but it's strata roll. Okay. Now, this should be another point. Upon the opening of a book of strata register under section 15, the MC shall come into existence consisting of all the parcel proprietors. So you are learning something new and important today, which is MC terdiri daripada all parcel proprietors. Ada yang belum tahu, hari ini saya nak bagi tahu perbadanan pengurusan itu bukan terdiri daripada 10 orang, 11 orang, 5 orang, 7 orang. The MC, perbadanan pengurusan terdiri daripada semua parcel proprietors. Proprietor ni owner lah, tetapi proprietor ni is a legal language, the legal jargon yang digunakan untuk perkataan owner. Okay, so semua parcel proprietor adalah the MC, the perbadanan pengurusan. Hopefully you learn, if you learn something today, you learn about this. Nanti ada lagi salah faham yang kata MC, nak salah ke MC yang duduk kat pejabat tu. MC kita semua, MC semua owners, okay. Okay, share units. Apa tu share units? Share units shown in the schedule of share units yang kita belajar tadi. When they want to undertake any strata development, you perlu sediakan schedule of share units. SIFUS, kan? Sijil Formula Unit Share. Formula, sijil formula, yeah. SIFUS, okay. Shown in the SIFUS, it specifies among others the voting rights of the parcel owner of a subdivided building. Hak mengundi. Remember my strata title just now, I showed you kan, hak mengundi saya ada 108 dari slash berapa puluh ribu untuk the total of the strata development. The formula for the calculation of allocated share units is provided in Strata Management Act. Sekarang ini sudah ada satu formula fix. Sebelum SMA, semua developer gunakan formula sendiri untuk calculate the share units. Sekarang ada satu standard way of calculating the share units. Parcel itu apa? So under SMA pula, there's another section on definitions. So it's under section 2. STA just now under section 4. We need to learn about these definitions first. Kemudian barulah kita boleh clear tentang the other matters lah. What is parcel? Parcel under SMA in relation to a building intended for subdivision means one of the individual units comprised therein, satu unit di dalam bangunan yang hendak dipecah bahagi. Okay, which which except in the case of accessory parcel is to be held under a separate strata title. Dia ada satu strata title untuk setiap petak. In relation to a land intended for subdivision, again, siapa yang tak clear? Subdivision under strata law di Malaysia boleh berlaku kepada bangunan dan juga boleh berlaku kepada tanah. Okay, siapa yang nak masuk ni? Azriana baru masuk. Okay, anyway, nak habis dah. Okay, so B, in relation to land intended for subdivision means one of the individual units of land parcels to be held under separate strata title. So land pun boleh dipecah bahagi, okay, dan akan result in a strata title, individual strata title. In relation to subdivided building means one of the individual unit, sama je, subdivision. Oh, this one is intended for subdivision. Ini bangunan sedia ada. Bangunan yang intended for subdivision means belum didirikan lagi subdivided building. C gives the opportunity for any existing building untuk dipecah bahagikan. Maknanya dulu held under one owner contohnya. Dia ada banyak, dia ada 100 dia ada 100 office lots kan, ataupun office office rooms ada dalam satu bangunan. Tiba-tiba owner tu kata, oh, I nak convert, lebih untung kalau saya jual satu-satu kepada different owners. So saya nak subdivide my building, boleh? Existing building boleh dibuat. Later on when you become a property practitioner, nak nasihatkan your boss, inilah salah satu strategi untuk generate income. Maybe you retain, katakan you boleh bahagi, subdivide the building into 200 office kan, 100 simpan untuk investment, untuk dapatkan rental, boleh income, 100 lagi boleh jual. Tapi ada implications dia nanti dari segi management. Anyway, so nak cakapnya boleh buat. Okay, so in relation to subdivided land means one of the individual lands which is held under yang tadi land intended, belum di subdivide lagi. So untuk satu tanah yang telah dah subdivide, you boleh subdivide lagi, okay, pecahkan lagi. Allocated share units, what's that? Share units adalah assigned to each parcel intended for subdivision by developer slice. Siapa yang buat? Is the licensed land surveyor yang akan tentukan the share units, okay. Dia akan measure dan dia akan calculate menggunakan formula yang diberikan under SMA just now. We mentioned, there's one formula to be used now. throughout Peninsula Malaysia. Okay. Where they have not been so assigned, the share units assigned under Section 8. Okay, so sama ada dikira menggunakan formula sendiri sebelum Strata Management Act itu diluluskan, dan sekarang ini Section 8 SMA telah mewajibkan penggunaan satu satu formula. We are going to do that. I don't think I have the time to discuss, but I have prepared a video on share units. Apa itu share units? Macam mana nak calculate share units? There's a separate video. So after this, you can go and have a look at that video. 11 minutes saja. What is common property? Common property according to SMA in relation to existing or proposed subdivided building or land means mana-mana bahagian of the lot or development area not a parcel, which is not a parcel, which is not accessory parcel, which is not provisional block. So selainnya adalah common property. Dan juga as I said before, the second qualifier ataupun second condition untuk sesuatu property menjadi common property under SMA ialah capable used or capable of being used. Digunakan atau boleh digunakan ataupun dinikmati oleh two or more parcel occupiers. Okay, so ini dia punya qualifier tadi tu. Dia lebih menerangkan lagi apa itu common property. Now, SMA has brought along a new concept which is limited common property. Okay, limited common property. Which is such part of the common property yang ini, mana-mana common property, yang mana such part of common property is a lot that is designated. Dia mesti di-designated dahulu, mesti ditentukan dahulu. Mesti designate as a limited common property, then only it is a common property. Designated in a comprehensive resolution, dalam ketetapan komprehensif. Mana, macam mana nak dapatkan comprehensive resolution? Melalui GM, general meeting, melalui pengundian dalam general meeting. Okay, resolution ini, ketetapan ni atau keputusan ni didapati bila meeting dijalankan. So if you do a strata management later on, yang pentingnya adalah buat meeting, GM kan, general meeting untuk dapatkan resolutions kalau ada apa-apa melibatkan semua owners, you mesti buat keputusan melalui meeting. Tak boleh buat certain things MC tak ada kuasa, the management committee of the management corporation tak ada kuasa untuk putuskan. Nanti MC you akan belajar. MC tu ada dua, satu tu management corporation, lagi satu management committee. Dia a bit confusing lah, tetapi satu tu perbadanan pengurusan, satu lagi ahli dia kan, majlis pengurusan. We will learn under SMA apa perbezaan antara management committee and management corporation. But anyway, limited common property besides must be designated in a comprehensive resolution for the benefit, for the exclusive benefit of two or more, but not all parcels. Yang ini berkaitan dengan users, having different users in a single strata development, a mixed development lah. Sebab ada certain common property yang certain users sahaja guna. For instance, retail hanya gunakan lift. For instance, residential hanya guna, hanya residential user yang gunakan swimming pool kan. Like what we mentioned yesterday kan. Exclusive benefit of two or more but not all. Tak semua akan pakai common property tersebut. Dan sudah designated kan di dalam comprehensive resolution. For which dan juga disertai dengan perakuan, certificate has been issued by the director of PTG yang memperakukan, certifying that the subsidiary management corporation has been constituted. Bila ada limited common property, mesti ada sub-MC yang menguruskan limited common property ini. Common property akan diuruskan oleh management corporation. Okay? Limited common property akan diuruskan oleh sub-MC, subsidiary management corporation. Ibu, anak, parent, child. Mesti ada parent dahulu, baru boleh ada children. Sebab mungkin ada lebih daripada satu limited common property. Case study will be Mount Kiara. Okay? sub MC, the provision is under section 17A STA. Oh my god, 1240. Anyway, limited common property are common features. Mixed development sahaja yang ada limited common property. What are mixed developments? Mixed developments bila ada more than one user. You ada, as I said before, you ada podium, retail. You ada tower, office. You ada satu lagi tower, service apartment. So you ada tiga different users di situ. So tiga users means you boleh designate limited common property untuk retail. You boleh designate limited common property untuk office tower. Contohnya lift ini hanya untuk office users sahaja. Retail punya users tak boleh masuk. Itu adalah kita panggil designated. Di mana tak boleh masuk kawasan larangan. Designated untuk office users sahaja. Untuk service apartment sama juga untuk keselamatan. Tak benarkan retail users untuk use the lift for the service apartment. So you have now the limited common property lift untuk service apartment. You have limited common property lift untuk office, kan? So dah ada dua limited common property di situ. Therefore, you need to have limited. You need to have a subsidiary MC for the office. You kena ada sub MC for the service apartment. Penat cakap, tapi nanti you akan learn more about this. Ha? It's a good thing to have a limited common property. Sebab nanti kalau lift rosak, lift office rosak, tak adalah semua tu kena tanggung, kan? Retail users dan service apartment tak perlu tanggung kerosakan bayaran the repairs for the for the office lift because they don't use the office lift, kan? So it's fair lah, it's fairer. Now more one or more sub MC can be created by MC. As I said, mesti ada MC dahulu. This is the Malaysian system. Mesti ada parent, baru ada anak-anak, baru ada the MCs, okay? To undertake the management maintenance of one limited common property. Okay, now what can be subdivided? Under section 6, we mentioned this yesterday, building or land. Okay, boleh dipecah bahagi. So under section 6, part 2 of STA, any building or buildings on alienated land that is held under one lot. Macam mana nak pastikan kalau kata tadi office tower, siapa nama tu, service apartment, retail berada under one lot. Katalah luas tanah tu sangat besar. Sebelum development tu you ada tiga lot berlainan. How do you make it into one lot? Siapa boleh jawab? National Land Court. Siapa boleh jawab? Ivan. How do you make sure you have one lot when you want to do a strata development? National Land Code. What's the land method? Good. Good. Amalgamation. Penyatuan. Huh? So, sekarang your knowledge, your theory about National Land Code kena pakai lagi. Jangan buang terus. Semua-semua knowledge tu simpan sampailah habis belajar, sampailah bekerja. Okay? So, must be held under one lot. Also must already be surveyed. Surveyed. Final title ini sebenarnya tak satu keperluan. Final title ni sebab dia nak suggest bahawa tanah itu mesti dah survey. Surveyed land area instead of provisional. Tetapi ada juga QT punya tanah, qualified title punya tanah yang dalam proses untuk ditukar kepada final title tapi sudah survey. So that those kind of lands yang sudah ada surveyed land area but being held under HSD. HSD boleh didirikan, boleh you submit your application for strata development. Boleh buat. As long as the land or the lot has been surveyed. Boleh jadi registry title or land office title, tetapi bila strata titles dikeluarkan, titles tu akan disimpan di registry, di PTG. Okay? The land title tak apa, land office. Tapi once you make or you construct or you develop a strata development on the title, title tanah tu pun dah akan dipindahkan ke PTG. Now, any alienated land, selain daripada bangunan or buildings on alienated land, any alienated land, mana-mana tanah yang diberi milik having two or more buildings held under QT. So, townhouse, terrace house, that detached house yesterday, sudah ada bangunan atasnya. You can, in fact, apply for subdivision, apply for strata titles, ya. Yeah? Held under QT has, which has been surveyed. Mesti ini, tanah itu mesti dah diukur halus. already has an approved certified plan. Bila sudah survey, JUPEM akan keluarkan CP. Okay? CP equals plan akui. Originally meant for multi-story buildings. Dulu in the 1980s, 1990s, strata titles were meant for high rise, but now you have low rise. You have horizontal strata juga yang boleh diberikan strata titles. SMA also enhanced the strata title issuance procedure by making it compulsory for developers to file SOP. Tadi kan I mentioned in the third slide, if I'm not mistaken, SOP, schedule of parcels, mesti di difailkan oleh developer kepada COB under section 6 SMA. Kenapa? Because once you file the SOP kepada COB, now you make it official bahawa ini adalah parcel, ini adalah accessory parcel, ini adalah common property. Okay, now no more issues yang mana dahulu selalu berlaku, developers they carve out, dijadikan common property kepada developers unit, for instance. They carve out the common properties, jadikan accessory parcels, for instance, dan dijual. Dah sekarang tak boleh lah. If you, dalam schedule of parcels tu, ini adalah parcel, ini adalah accessory parcel, ini adalah common property. Common property is common property. Tak boleh lagi you later on jual pula part of the common property as accessory parcel. Tak boleh. Mesti dapat kebenaran. Tak boleh sewenang-wenangnya. You convert the common property to become developers accessory units. Dahulu salah satu cara for developers to make extra money, extra profit from their strata development. Now cannot anymore. Sebab sudah ada provision under SMA section 6 sub 1. SOP is prepared by developers land surveyor oleh jurukur developer. Termasuklah location plan, story plan, delineation plan, ini plan boundary based on approved building plans, and it shows all the parcels with dimension. Ini susah kan nak baca, nanti kita tengok contoh. Dia akan tunjukkan dimensi, ukuran, areas, keluasan, share units. Dia akan tunjukkan share units, accessory parcelsnya di mana, common propertiesnya di mana, using the same format as approved strata plans, and the proposed share units. Dia akan tunjukkan proposed share units dan contoh. Then siapa diukur oleh surveyor dan mesti juga disertify bahawa can be subdivided, and developer cannot simply carve out any common property as before. A copy of the SOP must be exhibited at the sale office and also at the office of the developers supaya potential buyers boleh come and they can inspect the proposed strata development. Mana satu parcel, mana satu common property supaya later on tak ditipu oleh developer. Okay, so in pembangunan berfasa, in phase developments, the SOP shows the proposed quantum. Dia menunjukkan quantum, ukuran-ukuran, keluasan semua tu. For provisional share units for each provisional blocks. Dalam pembangunan berfasa, because maybe phase one is the one that is only, that is being constructed. Phase 2 in the future, phase 3 in the future kan. SOP tersebut, the schedule of parcel akan tunjukkan the proposed provisional share units, the proposed block just now. Provisional means proposed lah, belum dibuat lagi. Tetapi mesti dah ditunjukkan dalam SOP. Okay. The total share units, bila my one just now 108, bila dikumpul-kumpul-kumpulkan, we have 540 owners dalam my condo development. So, satu owner katakan 108. 108 kali 540, that is the aggregate share unit. Okay, totalnya. Any amendment to the SOP can boleh dibuat, tetapi as per the requirement of local authority, sekiranya dikehendaki oleh local authority dan juga dengan agreement of all purchasers of the development. Sedikit susah lah nak dapat sebab you dah jual, tiba-tiba developer nak carve out, nak make it into developer's unit. Adakah pembeli sedia ada bersetuju? Mungkin tidak, most probably not. In the case of any changes to SOP, developer must submit within 30 days from the date of alteration or revision of building plans. Mesti submit kepada COB. Okay, ini gambar-gambar sajalah, don't worry about this. So ini certification just now, this one, certificate mesti di certify under section 6 sub 3. Okay, dan ini this is example of SOP yang kita mention just now, the petak itself, sorry, the site plan, the petak, the petak, the luas, the quantum, the kegunaan, the accessory parcels, taman bumbung dan sebagainya, share units pun ditunjukkan sekali in the SOP. So this is a good example of a SOP. SOP yang mesti difailkan di COD by the developer. Dan developer tak boleh sewenang-wenang. Dia cannot simply change. Dia cannot simply add other units, kan? Another unit. Dia cannot change the keluasan, for instance. Dia cannot simply take out any accessory parcel. Mesti retain sebagaimana yang difailkan di COD. Who can apply? Who can apply proprietor of the allotted land according to section 6? Okay. Developer who is not the proprietor boleh juga, tetapi mesti menggunakan PA. PA is the power of attorney. It's an official letter yang memberi kuasa, yang menurun kuasa, bukan beri, yang menurun kuasa pemilik tanah kepada the proprietor. It's very dangerous, this PA, power of attorney. Because the power of attorney punya letter akan memberikan kuasa pemilik kepada developer. Means developer not only boleh apply for subdivision, developer juga boleh cagarkan tanah. Bahaya, bahaya, bahaya. Menggunakan power of attorney without the consent of the proprietor. Kan? Nampak bahayanya di situ. You dah turunkan kuasa you kepada developer. Beri kuasa, mutlak lah. Last time tengok tanah kena gadai. Okay now, when, bila, timing. Superstructure stage, ini tadi kita dah mention. And then I also mentioned about CPSP, the Certificate of Proposed Strata Plan within 3 months of the superstructure. What is, more importantly, what is the superstructure stage? The point when where the walls dividing the different parts of the building are completed. As I said earlier, partition dalaman tu kan, sudah disiapkan. Sebab kalau tak ada walls, tak ada partition dalaman, macam mana nak diukur kan by the surveyor. So superstructure stage is when the walls dividing the different parts of the buildings are completed. So bolehlah sekarang diukurkan the parcels, the common property. Okay. So bila saja dah dapat CPSP just now, the Certificate of Proposed Strata Plan, bolehlah apply for subdivision and followed by the opening of book of strata register pun sudah mentioned just now. How to apply, section 9 sub 1. How? Made to land administrator. Through land administrator for approval of director of PTG. Okay, kenapa ni OSC ya? That's why land administrator. OSC, siapa yang akan approve director PTG menggunakan form 1. Form 1 perlukan all these documents plus fees. Okay, dan di sini you tengok CPSP is one of it. CPSP, purpose name, issue document, issue CCC, SOP. CPSP, SOP, title, fees, dan butiran yang lain. Okay, so application done with RG, sudah mention just now. Okay, conditions, ini penting. Tanah, untuk tanah. Condition untuk tanah sebelum you boleh apply for strata title ataupun for building subdivision ataupun land subdivision. No, under section 9 sub 2, no application under subsection 1 shall be made unless, kecuali lah tanah itu di bawah final title. Tetapi walaupun dikatakan final title, qualified title but with surveyed land area pun cukup. Okay, sebab sudah dibenarkan ada guideline daripada PTG. Kedua, the use of land is not contrary to the land category and conditions. Maknanya, if the land is under commercial use, penggunaan tanah tu mestilah commercial use juga. This is where the SOHO, service apartment tu comes, ada sedikit grey area di situ. Tetapi captured by HDA yang mana membenarkan ministry to declare bahawa SOHO itu adalah residential. Service apartment tu walaupun dia ada commercial, walaupun digunakan sebagai sebagai rumah, tapi dibenarkan sebab ada pengecualian, sebab sudah di declare by the minister, oleh menteri KPKT. Tetapi basically penggunaan tanah tidak boleh berlawanan, not contrary to the title punya category and conditions. The third one is tanah itu free from encumbrances, not subject to any charge or any lien. Okay. Now, for phase developments, provision is under section 9A. So inilah bentuk provisional blocks. Provisional means tak siap lagi, cuma propose. You see the garis yang putus-putus ni, ini for future development, ya. Yeah? For future development. So this is known as the provisional blocks. Okay. For, again, ini akan tunjukkan you the share units quantum just now. Okay. So katakan sekarang ni ada phase 1. Phase 1 hanya nak dirikan menara A, menara B. So for block 5, block 6, ada 1,000 share units. 1,000 share units. So in the future, akan ada lagi 5 blocks. Okay. Blocks 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8 kan akan didirikan in the future. Okay. Dan setiap provisional block carries with them 1,000 share units. So the quantum total untuk semua satu development ni adalah all these share units, which is 8,000. Committed untuk provisional, provisional belum didirikan ialah 6,000. Faham? Hopefully faham. Okay, now again, di sini juga tunjuk kereta rentas, the cross section. For basement, you have B1, B2, and then you have ground floor, first floor. Ini podium. Ini adalah ground floor. Katakan the first three floors ni dibuat retail kan? Huh? Ground floor, kalau dalam title, ini adalah floor 1. Ini adalah floor 2, ini adalah floor 3 dan sebagainya. Now, application for low cost, section 9B membenarkan and state authority can classify building to be low cost building. Okay. Section part 3. Part 3 is under 5-4 minutes. Boleh siapkan. Okay, now we have the requirement for strata register or the provision for strata register under part 3. Yang tadi tu strata title dikeluarkan, tetapi untuk strata titles to take effect, the strata titles must be registered. So the registration of strata titles are provided under part 3 of STA. Sections 15 until 19. Section 15 is the provision yang mewajibkan strata register, whereby it states that the registrar shall prepare and maintain, bukan sahaja buka tetapi perlu maintain a register of strata titles yang dikenali sebagai strata register that include an index of individual parcels and attached accessory parcels, CPSP dan juga RDT, the register document of title. Dan simpannya DPTG, section 16 mengatakan selain daripada strata register tu, there must be two copies of document of title, the RDT, the IDT, untuk parcel dan untuk provisional block sekiranya ada. Atas nama siapa? Atas nama the proprietor, the person last registered as the proprietor of the lot. Itu pasal bila saja dokumen tu dah dikeluarkan, you need to transfer to the buyer. Okay? Registration of RDT must be under hand and seal of the registrar. I sudah mention just now. Section 17, apa effect of opening strata register? The common property will be vested in the MC. Tanah tadi tu, selain daripada accessory parcel. Selain daripada accessory parcel. Selain daripada common property, akan vest. Dia punya ownership tu akan vest kepada management corporation. Registrar will make a memorial in the RDT and IDT and return the IDT. Siapa yang akan pegang the IDT? The management corporation. Di mana dia akan simpan? Dalam peti besi. Peti besi di mana? Sama ada di office MC ataupun di bank. Sebab IDT ni sangat penting. Okay. Sebab ini menunjukkan ownership. A proof of ownership to the master lot. To the master title. Section 18, share values. Ini share units ni. It's the provision for share units. Section 18 of STA. Each parcel shall have a share value as approved by the director expressed in whole numbers. So for my one just now 108, dia tak boleh jadi 107.9, 108.5. No, it shall be in whole numbers. Section 19, same as section 18 but applicable for provisional blocks. Mesti dalam, mesti ada share units. Dan share units tu being expressed in whole numbers, nombor bulat. So for share units, sudah ada separate video Saifus not that important. Saifus bolehlah cakap must be obtained from Office of Lands and Mines required to show the allocated share units. Basically ini boleh baca sendiri. Tak ada apa pun. Saifus sijil. Yang penting di sini cara pengiraan unit share saja, which one, which is this. So all these are contained in my video, the 11 minute video. Okay. So, ini tak sempatlah nak habiskan the third schedule. Banyaknya tak sempat. No. Sempat. Sikit saja. 5 minutes boleh. Now, duties of parcel owners. Apakah tanggungjawab seorang parcel owner? You sudah dapat title. You sudah menjadi parcel owner. Apa tanggungjawab you? Apa you punya larangan? Okay. So, kita nak discuss two things saja. So, duties mesti allow. You mesti membenarkan MC or agent into the parcel. Tetapi sebelum MC datang mesti bagi notis dahulu. Selalunya notis bertulis, dilekatkan di pintu ataupun diletakkan dalam peti surat ataupun zaman moden ni you boleh WhatsApp saja notis tersebut. For inspection, notis mesti diberikan dahulu. Tanpa notis MC kalau nak masuk nanti dia paksa diri dia masuk, dia sudah trespass, dia sudah ceroboh. Okay. Selalunya MC nak masuk untuk inspection. Bau busuk ada orang komplain, MC pun datang untuk inspect, okay? Ataupun ada aduan tentang kebocoran unit bawah, dia pun nak masuk untuk inspect. Itu contoh dia. Dan juga bila dah confirm ada leakage dalam you punya unit, you enggan repair, MC boleh masuk untuk buat repairs and maintenance. Dan juga kalau katakan dinding luar, which is half-half kan, the boundary is you own the half of your bricks, so brick wall, the outer one belongs to the MC kan, sebagai common proprietor, sebagai other proprietors, sebagai common property. So kalau katakan ada kerosakan pada luar, ada cracks for instance, dia boleh masuk dalam dia punya rumah untuk jalankan repairs. Carry out any work ordered by authority and pay or assessment. Sekiranya ada any notice by authority untuk jalankan kerja pembaikan atau any work, perlu jalankan. Semua cukai, semua charge, semua bayaran perlu dibayar juga by the MC. Bill elektrik untuk koridor, bill lampu koridor, bill elektrik untuk lift sebagainya kena bayar outgoings. Cik, sorry, carry out any, salah. So just now carry out, yeah, carry out any work tetapi by the parcel owner lah. Pay assessment by the parcel owner lah. Contoh assessment di sini ialah the parcel rent just now, cukai petak tu perlu dibayar oleh parcel owner. Not only that, charges, the service charge perlu dibayar. Outgoings, dia punya cost ni, dia punya cost repairs, dia punya bill semua dia kena bayar sendiri, related to the parcel. Itu tanggungjawab seorang parcel owner. Keep his parcel in a good state of repair. Mestilah kalau rosak mesti repair. Kalau ada apa nama kerosakan mesti repair. Kalau what else sesuatu yang yalah repair lah, kalau rosak mesti repair, okay? Not cause nuisance, tidak menyebabkan kacau ganggu. Use his parcel according to approved plan. Kalau approved for residential mesti use as residential punya punya parcel or residential property. Sekiranya jual, mesti inform the MC of changes in proprietorship. Prohibition sebab tugas MC adalah to keep the strata role under satu section, bukan section 19, strata role. So, MC perlu update nama owner baru dalam dia punya strata role. Strata role dipegang oleh MC, strata register dipegang oleh PTG. Prohibitions, apa yang dilarang? Use his parcel for any purposes which may be injurious, yang boleh menyebabkan kerosakan kepada reputation of the building. Contohnya menjadikan sarang ayam, you know what I mean kan? Red light district tak boleh lah. Ataupun sarang penagihan dadah, drug punya den, tak boleh lah. Injurious to the reputation of the building. Use as fuel for any substance or material which may give rise to smoke, fumes or obnoxious smells. Any nuisance lah. Dan tak boleh throw or allow to fall any refuse or rubbish. Ini pernah on the common property. Buang putung rokok ke atas tanah. Buang chair atas daripada you punya balcony ke tingkat bawah. Itu semua lagi dah tak boleh kan. Happens before kan, especially ada cases before in low cost punya developments, dia buang sampah dia, rubbish bag, dia boleh buang saja melalui balcony. Tak boleh. Ni prohibition under STA. Keep any animal in his parcel or on common property which may cause annoyance, yang menyebabkan annoyance lah, sakit hati. Then, okay, as we said before, first time registration, strata title will be under the name of last registered proprietor. Then, selepas saja strata register dibuka under section 15, MC will come into existence. MC, who is MC? Is the body corporate. Body corporate in respect of which all proprietors are members. Ini yang you belajar hari ni, ya. Semua proprietor adalah MC, adalah management corporation. Okay. Semua. So nanti ada nak salahkan MC, Apa nak salahkan MC? You salahkan diri you sendiri. And sebab you are part of the management corporation. The title to the land on which the land is built will be transferred to the MC. You see in my, you saw in my strata title before, Perbadanan Pengurusan PN86 whatever kan. And the MC will take over the duties and obligations of the owner sebagai owner land and buildings, of the common property and the land. Termination. So, bilakah you end the strata title? This is provided under section 57. These are the three situations di mana the subdivision of the building will be terminated. Tak ada lagi strata titles untuk bangunan tersebut. One, bangunan itu sudah destroyed, totally destroyed. Sudah musnah, kebakaran, earthquake dan sebagainya, musnah. Tiada lagi subject matter of the title. So, therefore, tiada lagi subdivision of the building. Tak ada lagi strata titles. Second one, if the parcel proprietor seek to demolish the building, mereka sendiri, parcel proprietors tu bersatu hati hendak demolish the building. Kenapa dia nak demolish the building? Ada developer approach them, menawarkan untuk beli semua unit sebab developer nak redevelop the land. Yes. So the parcel proprietor nak demolish the building for redevelopment, boleh selepas efeknya no more subdivision of the building. Okay. Dan sekiranya tadi kalau building tu ada fire, kalau partially destroyed, dia nak runtuh, dia ada nak rebuild again, then the subdivision of the building pun terminated. Sekiranya ada 100 owners of the building and then ada satu orang comes in and buy all the different parcels. Sekarang ni ada satu owner. Now there is no more building subdivision. Sebab the different parcels dah come under one owner. Therefore, you do not have a subdivided building any longer. You will have a building, a purpose built, kalau office, office building lah. Kalau apartment dah menjadi satu residential building lah. Boleh jadi tak macam tu? Boleh. In other countries like Thailand for instance, developer bought out the parcel owners, dia beli dan dia invest, dia sewakan balik units tersebut. Application, macam mana cara application made to registrar using form 8 with the IDT of the lot, registrar will make memorial, dia akan tandakan, dia akan cacatkan, catatkan di dalam lot register, strata register juga, inform the director of survey. Apabila saja catatan telah dibuat, proprietors akan tidak lagi menjadi owner provisional of the parcels and the provisional blocks, and MC akan menjadi proprietor of the lot size sebagai trustee saja, sebagai pemegang amanah saja, tak ada lagi hak untuk jual. That's all. Okay, as I said earlier, your share units ada di sini. You go to your week five. Tak ada. I will make it, ini sebenarnya. So I will make it visible after you, after this. So you can watch the video. By the way, okay, by the way everyone, Thursday kita tak boleh adakan synchronous punya ini. So I akan buat activities untuk your tutorial dan lepas tu you bolehlah buat activities tersebut ya. Everybody setuju? Sejulah. Kan sebab dah datang kelas dah 2 minggu turut. This week kita akan buat asynchronous. I akan buat activity in Google Form. Okay? So that's all from me. Have a good lunch. I need to go 1:15. I ada something else. Bye-bye everyone. Terpaksa rushing today. Terpaksa rushing today. Kalau ada masalah,
ya, doktor.
Sama-sama. Tak faham, boleh terus tanya saya lepas ni, boleh? Okay, okay. Bye-bye.
Terima kasih, doktor.
Sama-sama. Okay. Hopefully clear, ya.